theme park groupie. Today I am in my very first indoor theme park. I am in Las Vegas, Nevada for the first time ever. So I wanted to check out this indoor theme park, which looks super cool. It's got coasters, it's got all sorts of stuff. Got off of the disco. That ride is so much fun, but you cannot do it on a full belly because it kind of swings around a lot. It is fun, but I would definitely avoid doing it right after a meal. Now we're gonna try the inverter. Just got off of the inverter, which is a very strange feeling. It's not like any ride I've ever ridden before. It just got to go slow. There's no G-force, it's just an arm that's holding you upside down. It's very strange, but I enjoyed it. Actually, a lot funner than I thought it was gonna be. All right, about to do bumper cars. Whoa, whoa, it's already moving. Let's see how this goes. I can't find my seatbelt. Oh, there it is. Alright. So we just got done. That was super fun. I wish I could take videos of the ride, but I understand. It is a lot of fun. My beautiful wife, just like last time at Wild Adventures, she was screaming after like 3 feet in the air. She starts screaming, and it felt like it hadn't even started yet. We barely moved it. She's like screaming the top of her lungs. Yes, top. And it was, luckily she had a mask on, so the decibels were a little bit lower than they could have been. Man, I'm native from Florida, so I really wish we would get some more indoor theme parks. Definitely blocks the sun completely out and have a nice neutral temperature with these huge AC vents above us. It's so nice. It was literally so much more aggressive than I thought it was gonna be. When you're up there, like it literally just like, it shakes you all around and it's so much faster and crazier when you're actually on it than it looks like when you're from down under. It's so much fun. It was like, I didn't expect all that. That was really cool. It comes out on Mac. Oh my gosh! That was definitely the best one yet. Canyon Blasters, I think it's called. Oh my word, it was so good. You literally just looped and looped and looped and looped. And there's one point where you go indoors completely and it's like pretty much pitch black, which is so cool. Kind of remind me a little bit of Space Mountain at Disney because it was just like pitch black. You don't really have any clue where you're going. I love that aspect, and I kind of wish the whole ride was in indoors like that. But man, this was so cool. It does bang you around a lot, and this is the first time my group is kind of like, yeah, maybe we should take a break because It is pretty rough. It's definitely my favorite ride so far.
We have a 4D special effects theater showing Ice Age, No Time for Nuts, and Scoob 4D Experience.
Angry Birds the Ride. I had not heard about this. Let me try it out.
We just got out of Angry Birds the Ride, which is kind of reminds me a lot of like Despicable Me and Jimmy Fallon from Universal. You kind of watch the video and the ride moves along the side of the screen, like the movements of the screen. And it was really cute. You know, it had like a funny little storyline based off Angry Birds, yeah. And I think it was pretty fun.
So they have mini golf, pirate bounty mini golf, and a party zone. So if you want to do birthday parties or something like that, it's a pretty cool area. I saw a video of this before I came and it looked really cool. I was thinking like the engineering behind it is really cool, how they just like dodge each other. And it seems like that and the swings are down today, which is kind of a bummer.
That one was crazy. You literally had no idea what you're swinging frontward and backward and you're spinning at the same time and the platform's moving side to side. It's so crazy. I'm glad it stopped when it did because I started feeling a little queasy toward the end. I think it's like the appropriate length to where if it was any longer, I wouldn't have liked it, but it was good.
They have rock climbing and bungee trampoline. It costs 70 credits. I'm not entirely sure how much the credits cost.
Sitting there, wait for it to go, and all of a sudden, you just fly up. That was fun. Well, I guess we made the complete circle. Pretty much the whole park is a complete circle. And once you get back to the entrance or the exit, you've done the whole thing. So I had a lot of fun. It was, you know, not to the caliber of Disney or Universal, if that's what you guys are expecting. But for a small little park to be indoors, to be this compact, the way all the rides kind of like interlock with each other, they're able to compact it in such a small space, which is great for an indoor theme park because they're able to have the complete closure, which is really cool. A lot of these rides, you do have to be mindful that they are spinning and they kind of will get you a little queasy a little bit. So my only advice is to not have a huge breakfast or a huge lunch before you come. It is open from 11 to midnight, so you have plenty of time to ride a ton of rides, go back out, get some food or whatever you want to do, and then come back in. They have food around. We didn't eat any of the food here. It's basically like pizza and hot dogs is kind of what I'm seeing. But there's plenty to do inside if you want to stay for the entire duration. Right now it's only $40 for a pass and $20 for a junior pass. And they also have fast pass options. But today, it is a Friday, but there's not a lot of people here. There's a good amount, but they're all pretty spread out with all the 4D shows, the rides, the food, all the stuff, the arcade games. So they do a really good job at spreading all the crowd around, which I really enjoyed because you didn't have to wait I mean, I think we had to wait one cycle of a ride one time. So we pretty much walked on every single ride, which was really nice. And I love that. But I had a lot of fun. And if you guys are in the Vegas area or you plan to take a trip in the future, it's definitely something that would be worth checking out, especially for the price point. And anything you do in Vegas is going to be expensive. But for $40 a pass, you definitely get your money's worth. If you guys did like this video, go ahead and like and subscribe. Thanks for watching Theme Park Review. We'll be right back.